From the home of the Bills since 1973, there's a look at the newly named New Era Field just outside of Buffalo, New York. The folks in Buffalo love their Bills, and a moment ago they entered to the delight of this sold-out crowd. They're set for football as their Bills will do battle. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line with the Cincinnati Bengals.
Let's go! Green, 39!
They go play action here on first down. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And they didn't wait long to take a shot there, that's for sure. But it falls incomplete, and it's second down. These two teams, Bills and Bengals, met in Cincinnati a year ago. It was Cincinnati behind a big day from A.J. Green. Who else? 187 receiving yards in that game. And they would go on to beat Buffalo. The Bengals would 20-16.
And what a revenge game for Cincinnati. The year before in Cincinnati, had lost at home to those Buffalo Bills.
McCarron. And oh, right away, he lost the football. And the Bengals grab it. And they'll have a short field to work with inside the 15 at the 13-yard line. The pocket collapsed around him. I know we talk about it a lot, but a QB has to have that sixth sense, doesn't it?
He really does. And I know of one team at one point was training their quarterback with that time frame. And anytime he didn't get rid of the ball within the right amount of time, they would blow a horn or blow a whistle to show him. This is what that time is, just what you're talking about, training him to understand this is the amount you have, make sure the ball's gone. Didn't happen in this case.
Second down, Dalton. Now he's hit, and Dalton lost the football. Now this is picked up by the Bills. He's at the 50. He's at the 30, the 20, and he will score. Touchdown, Buffalo. And that's a linebacker showing he can move pretty good with a football in his hand.
That's not just a short shuttle now. He took it and went a pretty good distance, didn't he? Did you get the 40 time on that?
I didn't, but he got 6 points out of it. I know that, and a great play for that defensive unit. With the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. So here's Dalton and the Bengals now, first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. First and 10 for Dalton. That's complete to John Ross. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion. Facing a second and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. On second down, here's Mixon, and he'll be taken down right around the 34 after a pickup of only a yard.
Whenever we talk about the best strong safeties, one word constantly comes up, and that's instincts. Being able to diagnose run or pass and make the appropriate moves.
He crashed down hard there. He was ready for that running play. First carry for Giovanni Bernard. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. Get there, get there. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues.
So after the defense gets you the ball on a takeaway and a fumble recovery of their own, you've got to reward them, don't you? You've got to stay out on the field, give them a chance to rest, and how about doing it the way they did it, running the football and picking it up on third down.
Yeah, would not have wanted to go 3 and out. They avoid that right there.
Yeah, they avoided the glares as they went back to the bench, didn't they?
Mixon with a first down carry. And he's going to take this one up only to about the 44-yard line. Jerry Hughes on the stop.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And a minimal gain here as he's up to about the 47-yard line. Give him 3 on the play, and just like that, it's third down.
Sometimes your philosophies get challenged at times you don't want them to. They did try to stick to the running game on the first two plays. Didn't amount to much.
And now facing a third and long at the outset of this drive. Third down, a shot here for Dalton. And this is going to be incomplete.
Certainly looked like they were getting ready to convert there on third down, but what an effort to get his hand on that one, knock it away, and brings up a fourth down decision.
So on fourth down, on comes the left-footed punter, Kevin Huber, to punt it away. Back deep here, Marcus Murphy. And this one hits at the 3 and then bounds into the end zone for a touchback. The Bills offense coming out, ready to take over. And last drive, obviously not what you're looking for. You've got the lead. You've got to protect the football.
So in other words, someone got lucky because they've been moving the ball really well and wearing them down. In this case, though, giving up the football doesn't make them very happy. They can't wait to get back out there and atone for it.
Yeah, try to atone for it here on this drive. Now the first carry for LeSean McCoy. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 2.
And that was a good run. This was only one of 9 guys to go over 1,000 yards in 2017, and I think you can't let him run wild here.
What do you think, 100 yards, the measuring stick?
Always. That is the threshold. You want to keep him under that if you want to play good defense.
First carry for Chris Ivory. They'll only get a couple up to about the 30.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
They run with their short yardage man, Ivory. And he's going to get to the 31, enough for the first down. They only get 2 there, but on 3rd and 1, that's all they needed to keep the drive going.
I know the game's changed. A lot of people would say it's evolved. Look, I'm a little bit Neanderthal, okay? I love this. No exotic formations, no misdirection. Just line up and run the darn ball, pick up the first down. I love it.
Yeah, 3rd and short, that's what you're supposed to do. Like you said, old school smash mouth football. Throwing on first, here's McCarron. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. It's a gain of 9 yards, and that'll make it 2nd and short. And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even begins. So throughout your practice sessions, you're going to want to be aware of him. Where is he lining up? What can he do? What kind of damage can he do to us downfield? And who can match up with him without weakening our overall defense? You're exactly right. It's a tough task to match up to him.
They try to throw on 2nd down, but this one is incomplete. They tried the throw on 2nd down, unsuccessful. Now it's 3rd and 1. Four down, four down. They'll try and run for it with McCoy. And he won't get to the marker as they're going to stop it for a second straight play right at the line of scrimmage.
I know it's the first half, but it's still hard to curb the enthusiasm for that stop. Third and one, and the offense can't get there. The defensive team has got to feel very good about themselves. Great job out-leveraging the offense.
On fourth down, Colton Schmidt to punt it away. Alex Erickson deep for Cincinnati. And a little too much mustard on that one. It hits a couple yards into the end zone. A missed opportunity there maybe to pin him back. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And things haven't started so well for this side. Two drives, two punts.
So now you've got to start looking not just at play calling, but which guy's going to step forward and say, okay, let's get this thing done. Because within that unit of 11, sometimes one guy can make a big-time play and break through the barrier.
On first and 10, here's Andy Dalton. Caught Eifert over the middle. And they'll get him down here at the 23. The completion good for three, and it's second down. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
And not much there. Maybe a yard up in the 24. The completion on first didn't get much, and now the run on second doesn't get a whole lot either.
Well, if you're a good play caller, you've already looked ahead and anticipated this type of situation. Already down in his play sheet, trying to dial up a big third down play.
On third down, Dalton. And that is incomplete. Micah Hyde, second team All-Pro a season ago, there on the coverage.
When I watched that play, I thought about what my coaches had told me in the past, the biggest teaching point. Get your head around. Locate the football so you can make a play on it while it's in the air. That's exactly what he did there. That was nice.
Here's Kevin Huber now. On for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Here's Murphy. Give him 11 yards that time on the return. And the Bills will take over the football with a first and 10. Here's the Buffalo offense now as they get set to take over here. And the results for them have not been strong to this point. Two drives have ended in a turnover and then a punt.
So would it be too snarky for me to say that they've shown improvement? Because you had two drives with turnovers. Now they punted it away, so at least they didn't turn it over. That's good, right?
You're going to get some angry users reaching out to you on social media.
Well, I don't mean to be. I was actually looking for the positive. Silver lining, you know.
And throwing to start the drive, but that went incomplete.
Had an open man that time, but ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. On second down, it's McCoy. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And that'll make it third and 13. Working from the gun here, McCarron. Going deep for Benjamin. And he can't quite intercept it. Zone coverage, free safety was there. Couldn't come up with it, and now it's fourth down.
Well, it certainly appears that they're going to try and keep getting him the football. That's the third time they've looked in his direction. Unfortunately, haven't completed one yet, but I'm not sure they're going to shy away from him. They feel like they've got something there, and they want to capitalize on it.
I think you're right. We're only in the first quarter, so a lot of opportunities ahead. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. Now the Cincinnati offense ready to see what they can do here. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Here's Joe Mixon as they start on the ground. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play there. Second down. Dalton throwing on second down. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And he'll get it up here this time to the 21. They'll give him a yard on the play, and that'll make it third down.
Well, it's tough to be a defender in today's NFL because there's so many things to account for in today's passing game, including the back sneaking out of the backfield. Not quite as bad as a turkey bowl where you have that center-eligible stuff, but still a lot of guys to account for.
To throw on third down, Dalton. He's got his man here, it's Green. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Green's first catch of the game, good for a first down.
I think it all came together there. In breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Dalton with a give here to Mixon. He'll be dropped shy of the 40 despite an excellent display of footwork. Tackle made there by Matt Milano.
What's the old expression, 3 yards in a cloud of dust? In this case, it's dust-covered pellets. It's no longer that old grass that we used to play on, right, and chew it up. Now we've got that artificial surface. You see the pellets go up. Still a nice play by the defense.
Off the play fake to Mixon. This is Dalton. Green with a catch left side. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. The connection since 2011, Dalton to Green for a Bengal first down.
And another thing that makes a comeback route really effective is that oftentimes after you've made the initial move, receiver's breaking away from the defensive back, and that makes it a really tough play to defend. A nice chunk of yardage picked up there.
Here's a give to Mixon, and he'll take it across midfield and into Buffalo territory. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
It's second down, Dalton looking. Being chased out left. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. They'll get 14 on that one. Good for a Bengal first down.
Well, that was man coverage. So once he decides to run with the football, there's no one to account for him, and he turns it into a nice gain.
Now a play fake here on first down. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. Call it a gain of 5. And it's a second down.
And the big guy catches the ball out of the backfield, and oftentimes that's quite a surprise to the guys playing defense because not ordinarily thought as a pass catcher, it often works when they decide to dial it up.
Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. Now whistles and a flag, and I believe a Bengal got going a little early there. The false start penalty, and now they're back to needing 10 yards on second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. shedding through the defense. And he's going to get this one down to the 30. It's Vontae Davis, the Pro Bowler, in on the stop.
He's definitely tough to get down. We just saw it right there. But how about what we did see? Pursuit, wrap up, and then the big finish with the tackle.
The Bengals on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 8. Dalton sets up play action. And they take him down. The Bills get to him. Lorenzo Alexander in there to get him for a loss of 9. And that'll lead to 4th down. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Quarterback gets hit.
So coming on now is the field goal unit. They're going to try for 3, and he'll need all the leg he's got here. This will be from 56 yards out. And this won't get there. Won't be online either. It's no good. Off to the right, and this score will stay right where it is.
Everything looked good. Good snap, good hold. Sometimes, though, the ball just doesn't want to go where you want it. And this one winds up no good.
So the missed 56-yarder, and now the flip side. Good starting field position at the 46 near midfield.
Let's go! 3-19!
They'll start the drive with a carry by McCoy. And nowhere really to go there. He'll take this up just shy of midfield. Geno Atkins, the Pro Bowler, in there on the stop.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Under 4 to go now as the clock runs and they come up on 2nd down.
3-19!
McCarron to throw on 2nd down. And he'll be hit from behind and taken down. Carlos Dunlap in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
Now a play fake. McCarron. It's caught. Jones. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A gain of 32 that time.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
So they'll come up in Bengals territory now with a 1st and 10 as they've got it to the 28-yard line. On 1st down, this is Ivory. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's 2nd down. Moving backwards on 1st down, never a good thing. What does that do for the mindset on 2nd down?
Well, it changes your play call, definitely, because as a play call, you're advancing yourself, thinking, okay, we're going to get a gain here. Now you've got to go back in reverse, come up with something to pick up not just the yardage lost, but gain a few extra.
McCarron throwing on 2nd. It's complete to Jeremy Curley. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for 3rd down. And now the passing game here in the 2nd quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it now, the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
And he's going to have a 1st down here as he gets this one to the 17-yard line. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
Here we go. 3-19. 3-19.
from the red zone now. It's McCarron. And this is caught off the deflection. Now before the second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. That first down completion only netted him three. Second and seven.
Single, single, single. Hurry up, here we go.
Ah! On second down, here's McCarron. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Charles Clay is tight in the intended target, and it's third down.
Sometimes the coverage is so good, no matter what you're doing on offense, you just can't shake anyone free. They try their best to find someone open, but they took away every passing alley, every angle, and shut the play down.
The Bills on third down. They've converted three out of five thus far. This is third and seven. Shotgun snap from McCarron. Left side here, caught by Clay. And now the Bengal defense here calling a timeout as the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in half number one. Field goal forthcoming for Steven Hauschka. And Hauschka's kick is good. And the lead moves to 10-0. So unable to convert for the touchdown inside the red zone, but they do come away with three.
Yeah, it's a 32-yarder. That's essentially an extra point nowadays, right? Because it's 33 as a general rule for these guys. So it should be a simple kick. But you know what's really strange nowadays? When they miss an extra point, I think they carry that with them longer than missing a field goal, because an extra point's supposed to be automatic.
Absolutely, and I would think even field goals inside of 30 yards, even though they're substantially shorter than a PAT, it just has a different feel, doesn't it?
A different feel, a different vibe. That's what I get from all the kickers I talk to. They always say, if I miss an extra point, that's the one that bothers me more.
And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. The Bengals offense now, they head back onto the field. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Closer.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
Boyd's the target, and he has it over the middle. And before this second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout, as the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number two. Able to get seven on that first down pass play. Second and three. Looking to throw on second down. Dalton. Oh, the rookie nearly had the pick. Probably should have had it. Third down now.
It's been my observation, there's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit, but only the second quarter, a lot of time to change things. They look to throw on third with Dalton. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. 12 yards that time and a Cincinnati first down. Dalton. Pressure here, and down he goes. Sacked back at about the 43-yard line. Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. To throw on second down. Dalton. And the catch good. It's Eifert. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. They get 14 back, but it leads now to a third down. So we've reached halftime here in Orchard Park with the Bills taking the lead into the break. As we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. On the return, it's Alex Erickson. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The Bengal offense now with a football first here to begin quarter number three. They come out here with a zero on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there, because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset, but typically halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that. And in this case, are they upset that the plays weren't working because of execution, or did they think just they were just bad plays to call?
Yeah.
We'll find out pretty quickly here if they feel like they had something going, but they just need to do it a little bit better or not.
We'll find out. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you, because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is, because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
Third and two for Dalton. And he gets this up to the 34, out of bounds there. Dalton to Green for a Cincinnati first.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out to the sideline and make a catch.
Andy Dalton now 12 of 15 throwing the ball, 80% so far, and it's first and 10. A handoff to Mixon. And he'll get this up to about the 40. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
Second down, Dalton. He gets this one to Boyd. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive. Continuing to steadily move the ball down the field. Not big play after big play, but these moderate gains getting him first downs.
And you know what they add up to, right? If you continue that pace and you continue to move it downfield, they add up into 6 points. That's exactly what you're looking for.
Now Dalton. And Green with a catch left side. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. It's a Bengal first down, a pickup of 11. Andy Dalton now, 5 straight completions here in this second half, first and 10. Dalton, first and 10. And the grab by Croft. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and 8.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
So second and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. And again, Andy Dalton to throw. Buying time to his left. He'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of 3, but now it's third down. And the Bengals on third down. They've hit 4 of 7. This will be 3rd and 5. Dalton now to pass. Oh, I can't hang on to it. Almost intercepted. They would have loved the first pick of the game there, but at least it does get them to fourth down.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? The zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
And this is off target to the left. Didn't get there anyway. It's no good. So here's the Bills offense. Now they get ready for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the ball back here. Didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
And how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. On first down, McCarron, incomplete. He was trying to get it to LeSean McCoy, and that'll bring up second down.
Well, we progressed through the preseason, so let's prognosticate about the regular season. NFC.
Can we overanalyze?
Yeah, I want to overanalyze, too. NFC, the four divisions, who do you have winning them?
Let's start in the East. The Philadelphia Eagles won the Super Bowl last year, got better in the offseason. I think they win their division again, although Dallas will make a strong run at them.
Okay. And the South, you're saying you like Atlanta.
Yeah, I do like Atlanta to get back to the top. Tough division, 3 teams in the playoffs last year. Atlanta, New Orleans, which won the division, and Carolina.
Going west, who do you have out there?
The Rams. They took over for the Seahawks last year. I expect them to stay on the top of the heap. But let's face it, a lot of excitement in San Francisco with Jimmy Garoppolo.
In the north, can Green Bay overtake Minnesota?
They can, but I don't think that they will. I think the Vikings defense carries them home. Kirk Cousins, their new quarterback. The Packers will challenge in a big way, but keep an eye on Detroit as well.
Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. 7 yards on the play, and that's going to bring up a fourth down.
Whether you're playing West Coast offense or not, one of the maxims of the West Coast offense is you're either throwing a touchdown or a check down. In other words, look for the big shot, but be smart. And I think they did exactly that on that play. They didn't get the first down, but they're taking care of the ball well.
Yeah, and being rightly cautious with that lead here in the second half. And this will hit just beyond the goal line as it's into the end zone for a touchback. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And they had compiled a pretty long drive last time. Unfortunately, though, it ended with no points after the missed field goal.
And that can hurt the psyche of a team because as they drove downfield, you know you're never supposed to count points in your mind until they go up on the board. But let's face it, we've been there. We've seen teams before. They were counting on those points. They didn't get them. Can they come back now, start over again, and grind it out?
He's going to air it out deep for Green. That's caught at the 25. And he finally goes down at the 23-yard line. A big play, Dalton, to his favorite receiver, Green. 57 yards. So first and 10 now in Buffalo territory at the 23. Now Dalton with a first and 10. Looking left side and he's got a man. That's Green. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed. Because you hit a guy on the run like that, you often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule. Play action here with Dalton. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, This feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
They give to Mixon to try to pick it up. And he gets the first down yardage before he's brought down just outside the 10 at the 11. A gain of 4 that time as the drive continues.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
The first down throw coming for Dalton. This will be caught at about the 5. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. 2nd and 3. Now Mixon. And he'll be stopped about a yard shy of the goal line after a pickup of about 3.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the 3rd quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
On 3rd down, Mixon, and he takes it into the end zone. Touchdown, Bengals. A great play there, punching it in from a yard away. And the Bengals have got it back to a 1-score game. On for the point after is Randy Bullock. Bullock good on the extra point, and that'll cut it to 3 at 10-7. Bullock out now to kick this one away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Bills' offense now, they get set to head back onto the field. Certainly want to avoid what they had to do last possession, and that was punt the football, because this game's starting to tighten up.
In a basketball sense, you think about taking a little bit of the air out of the ball, right? Maybe milk some clock, limit the possessions. In this case, they might want to do the same thing, but control the game offensively. Put together some first downs, put together a drive, and keep it away from them.
And he'll get this one up to the 26. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
Tough first half for him, unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
Set, blue lining.
Back now in Buffalo. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the 4th quarter.
Here we go. Blue lining.
They'll go again to McCoy. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. Vontaze Burfict, the one to get him down.
All right, that's a decent game there, but it hasn't been his best game overall. So I wonder what the mindset is of his team. Do they want him to handle the football and try and close this game out? Or are they going to make an alternative plan and maybe go in a different direction?
I think they need him, and this is his time to shine.
All right, here we go.
Now here's McCarron on 3rd. And this one is incomplete.
We've seen these defenses make enough opportunistic plays to keep this one low scoring. Flying around, making plays on the ball, and we see yet another errant throw as a result.
Here's Colton Schmidt now. He's been terrific so far. Yeah.
first kick, 47. This one looks good as well. This is taken at about the 14. Now a hit and a loose football.
And that's what friends are for.
Right. As the returner, you know who you're buying dinner for later.
Oh, without a doubt, because he just took care of you and your team in a big way. You know, you turned it over there. That's a big momentum changer and put your defense in a bad spot.
And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. It's a Bengal first down, a pickup of 11. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
First and 10 for Dalton. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. 6 yards on the pickup, and it'll make it second down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
It's second down. Dalton looking. Throwing the out route and complete. That's Boyd. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. A good pickup there, a 22.
But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route. And what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing. And they got it done.
On first and 10, here's Andy Dalton. And he's caught right at the 10-yard line. And he will take it on in for a Bengals touchdown. A.J. Green, 32 yards. And the Bengals have taken the lead here in the fourth. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You've got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions and I'd hear 9 from the receivers, that meant fly route, go, look out. That was the 9, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
Bullock out now to kick this one away. Here's Tywan Jones on the return. And now running right through it. And now look at him go. 30, past the 20. And all the way home for a Bills touchdown. A great effort there. And the Bills have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter. They had just lost the lead. That deficit sure didn't take long to erase. They return the ensuing kickoff for a touchdown.
Love the thunderbolt that just came out of that one that puts them in the end zone and back in the lead. Your only question, your defense just gave up a score that puts you behind. Well, that score you just added on the board will energize them? Or do they have to go back out there and they're a tired unit? We'll soon see.
So now the other return teams out there as they'll try to duplicate what they just saw. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. Well, things are starting to move in the right direction. They get the touchdown last drive, then their defense gets them the football back.
Yeah, now they have a chance to get the lead if they can put something together here. And I'm eager to see how they decide to do it. They want to be methodical, or do they want to take the big strike and go after it right now?
On first and 10, Dalton caught Eifert over the middle. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. Give him a couple on the catch at second and 8.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
So second and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. Dalton throwing on second down. Got his man. It's Eifert. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
The completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught, and you don't give up much run after the catch.
The offense on third down tonight, they're hitting at 60%, 6 out of 10 thus far. They're looking at third in the nose of the football. Off the play fake to Mixon. This is Dalton. Dumps it off to Mixon. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. Officially a gain of just a yard there, but they do convert on third and inches.
And that's understanding where the markers are, because it's not just running to them. Because on the catch, you could actually be pushed back before the first down. It's getting past it and allowing that opportunity to drift back towards the first down line and still having picked it up. Really well run.
Underneath, this is Bernard. And certainly some style points there on the spin. Not a whole lot thereafter, but still a pretty good gain. It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and it'll be second and about a yard.
As a passer, you're always trying to find that open window to throw the ball downfield. How about this one? Right in the middle of the field, right in the heart of a defense.
That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and 1. Now they run with Mixon, and he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains.
Second and 1 is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. But I'll bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs, and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
Clock running, under 4 to play now as they come up on first and 10. From the gun, Dalton looks to throw. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
What's the old adage? Be quick, but don't hurry. Well, that went right out the window there. He was hurried, harassed. That ball had to be gotten rid of, otherwise he was going to get sacked.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Another look for Dalton on second and 10. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. He was looking for his favorite target, A.J. Green, that time. And it's third down.
Well, they're slinging it. And then there's one you got to put a timer on, huh? I mean, that one came in hot.
That came in hot, but overthrown, out of his reach and incomplete. Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. And that will be incomplete as well.
So much of this game is about leverage. We always talk about low man wins in the trenches. Well, it's like that at just about every position. And sometimes, if you lose that leverage and you're losing the battle, just jump up at the line of scrimmage and try and bat the ball away. And that's exactly what happened there.
Here's Kevin Huber now, as he's on to punt for Cincinnati. He's averaging just under 50 yards a punt as he gets this away. Now the Bills offense gets ready to head back onto the field. A little less than 4 minutes remaining, and the margin for error is small with this slim lead. Operate within your 4-minute offense here, Charles?
Definitely. Remember, the 4-minute offense doesn't always correspond to what's up on the clock. What they need to do is play a little bit of keep away right now. Run the clock down. Make sure their opponent doesn't get the ball back. Their dream scenario, get enough first downs and make them eat up their timeouts so the game ends when you're kneeling down with the football.
This complete to the tight end, Clay. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
I got the sense that the defense created a little momentum for them there, didn't they?
Did their job, forced the punt. Now, nice start to the drive. Offense has to do their part.
Yeah, they certainly do, but what a great start for them. They've got to go thank the guys on D.
Second and five after the five-yard completion on first down. McCarron now on the bootleg. Caught. This is Ivory. And they'll bring him down here up at about the 22-yard line. And 5 yards on the play there as the drive will continue.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Here we go.
On first and 10, here's A.J. McCarron. Caught on the left side by Benjamin. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. McCarron now 6 for 6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's first and 10. Now a first down carry here for McCoy. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 45. And whistles, and we're going to have another stoppage of play as they call the timeout on defense with 1:53 left. Another run. This time, it's Ivory. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. And now the Bengals are going to call another timeout. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Carry now for McCoy. And across midfield he goes and into Bengal territory. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Again, it's McCoy, and he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about four to go. And the trend continues here in the fourth like it was in the first, second, and third. He's had nowhere to run.
And you're probably thinking to yourself, why do they keep feeding him the football? Well, they trust him first and foremost. They do believe that over time he might actually pop one of these runs. The bottom line is, he takes care of the ball well for them, so they'll keep handing it to him.
And this is going to be incomplete.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they were unsuccessful.
Here's Colton Schmidt now, as he's on for the fifth time here today. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. The Bengal offense now gets set to head back out onto the field. They're only in need of a field goal, a decent amount of time on the clock. So tell me if I'm wrong. You don't have to be too panicked here.
No, not at all. I agree with you. And this is where your preparation and your confidence comes into play. They've worked on these situations.
Yeah, they practice this all the time.
They practice it all the time. They know what they want to get done. And in a lot of cases, the great competitors, they love this situation. They think they can go ahead and get it done.
They practiced it. We'll see if practice makes perfect. And he'll take this one up to about the 6-yard line. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and it'll be a second down. And with just over 40 seconds now remaining, he gets up and spikes it. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. They'll look to throw. He's got his man, Boyd. Give him 6 yards, and they do convert on third. First down now, but the clock continues to move. And now the spike comes with 28 seconds left on the clock. One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. They keep the game alive, at least for the moment, as it's a first down. Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play where still you're wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot.
So that'll do it for my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. The Bills are victorious as we say so long from Buffalo.